Hi, this is a short video on natural exponential function. So natural exponential function is f of x equals e to the power x, where x is going to be a real number, but what is e? So if you consider this expression, 1 plus 1 over n to the power n, what is going to happen with this expression is you're going to plug in larger and larger values of n. Well, when you make n, you can check this math on your own. I'm just going to tell you what the values are. When n is 100, this number is going to be approximately 2.7048138, etc. It's an irrational number, it keeps on going. When you make n 10,000, that number is going to be 2.718149, approximately. When you make n a million, that number becomes 2.718205 approximately. So you can probably notice that this number is not changing much anymore. This number is definitely growing, but not by a lot. And even though I jumped from 10,000 to a million, my number grew very little. My change occurred in the fourth decimal place. So what happens if n is going to continue growing without bound or approach infinity? That number is going to approach to e, which is approximately 2.7182818, etc. So this is our number. It has a lot of applications in science, finances, and other fields. And let's just graph the function, see what we're getting here. So using your calculator, you can figure out what these numbers are going to be for 3. For x equals 3, that's approximately 20.1. For 2, it's 7.4. Approximately, these are approximate values. For 1, is going to be approximately 2.7. For 0, it's 1, of course. For 1, it's 0.4, approximately. For 2, it's approximately 0.13. And for 3, it's approximately 0.05. Okay, we'll just plot the points. So 0, 1, 1, 2.7, 2, 7.4. We don't have enough room for that one. Over here, it's approximately 0.4, 0.13, and this is what the graph is going to look like. It is an increasing exponential function. So let's write some facts. It's obviously increasing. It is going to have a range, just like other basic exponential functions, from 0 to infinity. It does have a y-intercept at 0.01. Okay? That's all you need to know about this.